Mr. Britling temporized by saying he would make inquiries, and put Mr. Vanderpont off for 2 days. Then he decided to go up to London with him and make inquiries on the spot. Mr. Vanderpont did not discover his family, but Mr. Britling discovered the profound truth of a comment of Herr Heinrich's, which he had hitherto considered utterly trivial, but which had nevertheless stuck in his memory. "The English," Herr Heinrich had said, "do not understand indexing. It is the root of all good organization." Finally, Mr. Vanderpont adopted the irregular course of asking every Belgian he met if they had seen anyone from his district in Antwerp, if they had heard of the name of Vanderpont, if they had encountered so-and-so or so-and-so. And by obstinacy and good fortune, he really got on to the track of Madame Vanderpont. She had been carried off into Kent, and a day later the Dower House was the scene of a happy reunion. Madame was a slender lady, dressed well and plainly, with a Belgian common sense and a Catholic reserve, and André was like a child of wax, delicate and charming and unsubstantial. It seemed incredible that he could ever grow into anything so buoyant and incessant as his father. The Britling boys had to be warned not to damage him. A sitting room was handed over to the Belgians for their private use, and for a time the two families settled into the Dower House side by side. Anglo-French became the table language of the household. It hampered Mr. Britling very considerably, and both families set themselves to much unrecorded observation, much unspoken mutual criticism, and the exercise of great patience. It was tiresome for the English.